Hello, everybody. Welcome to Travel in Taiwan. This time, let's go to Lanyu or Orchid Island.
In this video, I will show you images and footage of a trip we made last month to the beautiful island of Lanyu, also known as Orchid Island, which is located off the coast of Taitung in southeastern Taiwan. Here you can see Taiwan, the map of Taiwan and Lanyu. We started our trip at Taipei as usual and took the train down the east coast to Yiran, Hualien, and further down to Taitung. From there we took the ferry. There you can see Taitung. North of Taitung is a Chu Kuang Harbor. From there you can take a ferry to Green Island and further down to Lanyu, Orchid Island. A beautiful island. This is how it looks. It's one big rock and there's a coastal road circling the island and connecting a few villages like Yeyo, Hongtou. Further down there are no villages but interesting rocks like the Dragon Head Rock. And then on the east coast there are two villages. One is called Ibarino in the indigenous language, or Ye-in in Mandarin, and Dongqing. And further north there are some more rocks like the Township Rock. And on the northwestern side there is the Orchid Island Lighthouse. And then there's Kaiyuan Harbor and Yeyo Village. And there you can see the airport as well. So we took the train from Taipei and we took the night train, which starts at 11 in the evening and takes 7 hours to get to Taitung. And we tried to get some sleep and we arrived at Taitung at 6 o'clock and then took a taxi to Chu Kuang Harbor, which takes about 10 minutes or so. There you can see the ferries, and it was early in the morning, so not much going on there. There you can see some fishing boats. You can see the harbor manager, fishing boat. It's a small harbor north of Taitung. And we got the tickets at the ticket hall here. And then we went to the ferry, which is somewhere behind the boats in the background there. Some fishing boats again. And there you can see our ferry. And there you can see some other passengers, some travel groups, tour groups. And then we started our trip. This is a ferry to Green Island. And we slowly left the harbor. I went straight to the upper deck because I like to sit outside, and there I met some tour group elder people who were happy to see a foreigner. And then after leaving the harbor, the ferry followed the coast for a while, and there you can see the high mountains of southeastern Taiwan. And as you can see, the sea was calm and the weather was fine, no rain, which is not always the case. Sometimes the sea can be very rough and it can be quite rocky. There you can see the sun was shining actually, although it was cloudy, and everyone on board was looking forward to get to Lanyu. It was the first time for us, so we didn't know what to expect. And we were very excited. There you can see Green Island in the distance. You can see the island for an hour or so on the left side. It's much closer to the coast than Lanyu. Lanyu was open sea, you couldn't see Taiwan anymore, and you couldn't see Lanyu yet. And my fellow travelers were sleeping inside, like many other people. I don't like to stay inside, I like it on the deck outside, watching the waves and the wind. So the ferry takes about 2.5 hours to the island, and they see the island for the first time. We saw the island for the first time. It's a huge big rock in the ocean. And there you can see some of the interesting rocks on the left side and on the right side. My first impression was, oh, the mountains are quite high. I didn't expect that. And it's a very green island. Not many people live there, about a few thousand only. There you can see that the mountains are quite tall, high. I think the highest are about 500 meters above sea level. And it's a very green island, there's a lot of trees. And then we approach Kaiyuan Harbor, which is on the west coast, the only harbor on the island. And in the background you can see the Mantou Rock, or Steam Bun Rock. And there are not many ships, there are just small fishing boats. And then the owner of our guest house picked us up at the harbor. And he did drive us to the guest house. You can see the first village. He drove us to the guest house and showed us a bit of the village, you know, of the island. And our guest house was in Yuren village on the west coast. We also passed the this little airport there, the small airport. And here you can see little Lanyu, the small island off the coast of Lanyu. And here our guest house was at Yuren village. And that's the guest house, quite new, but nothing special. Then I went straight to the coast to have a look. There's a small beach there, and there was other people swimming, tourists. And there you can see the boats Lanyu is well known for the canoes. There you can see another strange rock. So this was around noon time, and the weather was fine. It's quite hot actually. And there, close to the guest house, there are two churches. And these are taro fields, and you can see some goats there. Then we had lunch at Yeo village, close to the harbor, and we had flying fish noodle soup and fried rice with flying fish. And this soup, which was a bit oily. Then we had to look around at Yeo village. We saw some drying fish there, flying fish drying in the sun. So we went there in May, and May is a flying fish season. You can see fish drying all over the island. Then we had a look, there we saw a church in Yeo village. It's quite nice. Small lane there. Then we went to the high school of Lanyu, which is quite beautiful because of the patterns there. And it's from there you can see the Mantou Rock. Looks like a mantou, like a steam bun. Then this is also at Yeo, they saw more canoes, and they were quite pretty, clean and well painted, very nice. But you're not allowed to touch them. I didn't know that before the trip. Then we saw some pigs. You can see a lot of animals all over the island. Pigs, goats, dogs, cats. So if you drive or ride a scooter, you have to be careful. Also look out for the roaming animals. Then we went to close to Kailan Harbor. We took scooters, the guesthouse scooters, motor scooters, and we drove the road to Kailan Harbor. And there's a small lighthouse on a hill there. And then you have a great views. There's the harbor. And there you can see motor scooters you can rent at the harbor. And there's also the only gas station on the island, which is good to know, because you always have to look out that you have enough gas in your tank, because there's only one gas station. Also at the harbor we saw a fishing boat where the fishermen unloaded the fish. They just threw it on the ground there. Quite a lot of flying fish. The fish is not very big, maybe 20 centimeters in length. Big eyes. And the kids there decided it was too hot and they just jumped into the harbor. Simple joy. It was actually quite hot on that day. This is how they prepare the fish. Not very hygienic. And then they dry the fish in the sun. Then we went further up the coast to see the Lanyu lighthouse, which is on a hill. And there's a small road from the main road up the hill. And then you can see great views across the ocean. The lighthouse, this is the lighthouse itself, is nice, but you cannot get close to it. So it's a bit disappointing. Then in the evening we went, the owner of the guest house took us on a little boat trip. He's also a fisherman, so he took us on the boat and showed us how he pulls in the net with the fish, the flying fish. And he actually caught quite a lot of fish. See the big-eyed flying fish. In the net there were also some smaller fish and longer fish, and also another bigger one. There's a bigger one. So that was fun. So guest houses might arrange this kind of fishing experience. Then the next morning I went to the coast and early. And I saw this scenery, which looked a bit more like island or Scotland than a tropical island. And the coast there is quite rocky. I don't know, sandy beach or something. I did make a short time lapse. Interesting how the clouds were moving across the sky. Then our photographer went on a little scooter trip down the south, to the south, and they saw some goats and made pictures. So you can see goats all over the island, and sometimes they just walk on the street there. But they are always nice to watch. A bit shy, but you can get good shots of them. Then we had breakfast, and after breakfast our guest house owners arranged a snorkeling trip for us. So we went to a spot close to the airport, and we were really amazed by the beautiful coral reefs there. A lot of different tropical fish and a lot of different corals. And we had the live vests on and had these floating rings. So it was just floating at the surface. And you could see quite a lot of beautiful fish. It's like swimming in an aquarium. So this is definitely something you should do if you visit Lanyu. Make sure that you go on a snorkeling or a diving trip if you can dive. It's really beautiful. Visibility was great at the time. Then we went to the other side of the island, to the east coast, and there's a road across the mountains to the other side from where you have great views. There you can see Yuren village, and further up the coast to the left is Hongtou village. In Yuren village we saw some pigs on the road. They were actually crossing the road, disregarding any traffic. And you can see pigs all over the place. Then we went further north to Dongqing, and there's the bay, Dongqing Bay, where you can see the sunrise in the morning. So if you want to see the sunrise, you might want to stay in a guest house at Dongqing, not on the east coast, not on the west coast. And then there we had lunch at this restaurant, which has an interesting interior designer. And for lunch we had a simple meal, cold noodles and fried rice and some terry noodles. And there was a cat sitting on the windowsill, and the neck was injured. If you like cats, there are lots of cats over land. Oh, by the way, all the photos on this video are made by our photographer Aqua. Then I walked around Dongqing a little bit and saw some more pigs. And those were kept in an enclosure. And it was lunchtime, so they were sleeping. And there you can see this is how the mountains look in Lanyu. Lush forest. And there you can see more goats. More pigs. You can see a lot of junk as well around the villages. And this is Dongqing Bay again. And this is the main road through Dongqing village. Not much going on there. And those canoes are quite, you can see them quite often in pictures of sunrises, because people go to this beach to shoot the sunrise, which the sun will rise somewhere on the left side there. And at Dongqing there's also this interesting pillar with motifs of cow canoes and flying fish and the silver helmets worn by the people during festivals. And there's also an art studio where we did take some pictures. There's a pillar again, and there's some more dry fish. You can see we had a lot of fun there on the island. And this is actually a bus station. There is indeed a bus service which circles the island a few times a day, but it's more for locals, not for tourists. And behind Dongqing village on a hill there's a cross, and there you have great views. And then we went further up the coast to the lover's cave, which is not actually a cave, but just a hole in the wall there. There you can see the bay again. And it was actually quite cloudy there, but it was not raining. Maybe it was raining in the mountains. And there you can see a huge rock, and then there's a hole in the wall. To get there you have to go north of Dongqing and then look for a small road on the right side. There's no sign, so you have just to look for a small road down to the coast. And then you can get close to the hole there, but you have to be careful because the stones are quite sharp. So don't wear flip-flops. And we did look around and took some photos. Quite an interesting place. Interesting volcanic rock. You can see the hole. There's water down there. It's quite deep, so you don't want to get too close. You don't want to fall down there. This looks more dangerous than it actually was. But you have to be careful because it's quite high up. And this looks like a head. Quite nice silhouette. French dogs are among the scenic attractions of Lanyu. Lanyu is a very beautiful place with a lot of interesting scenery. Then we saw goats coming from the plain to they gathered at this rock, and we found out that goats like to go to higher places in the evening. Maybe they feel safer there, I don't know. And they climb very high up to the rocks, and they could climb this. I wonder where they sleep at night, because there's no flat spaces there. You can see a lot of goats all over the island. They are everywhere. Coming and they cross the water there. I like goats. It's fun watching them, especially the little ones. So this was late in the afternoon, and they probably came here to stay for the night. That's my guess. This is a typical scene of Lanyu. If you see pictures of Taiwan with goats on rocks, then definitely must be in Lanyu. Then we said goodbye to the goats and went further up the coast to see more strange rocks. First, the what's called the warship rock or battleship rock, which sits a bit off the coast and looks from afar like a battleship. And the beauty rock is this one, also very strange, and right by the main road. This is on the northern side of the island. Then we went further back to the western coast, past the harbor, and south of Yuren village is this spot where you can see the sunset, but we didn't have luck with the weather, so the sun was somewhere behind the clouds there. But nevertheless, this is quite a beautiful spot, and there you can see there are also goats on the rocks there. Then I did make a little time lapse again without the sun, but I liked how the clouds were moving across the sky. It was actually quite a bit darker than it looks like. You can see the mantle rock. It looks like from this angle it looks very round. Then then it was time to for dinner, and we had beef noodles. Strangely, they don't have seem to have goat meat noodles. And we try this drink. This is a screw. It's not a pineapple. It's a screw pine fruit drink. I didn't try it, so I'm not sure how it tastes. Probably not that special. Then on the next morning, I went up very early and went to the weather station, which is on a hill on the road connecting the west and the east coast. And from there, you have great view across the eastern coast, and they can see the sunrise. Unfortunately, the sun was behind the clouds again, but amazingly beautiful up there. So if you want to see the sunrise, make sure you get up early and ride a scooter up there to the weather station. Then after the sunrise, I went, it was still early in the morning, like 7 o'clock, and I took the I rode the scooter down to the east coast and then around the southern coast. I made a longer video of me riding the scooter, and it's somewhere on the channel, on the YouTube channel here. This is a faster version. Well, the road is a bit bumpy and the video is not, it's quite shaky, so I don't. But at least you can see how it looks, how it is when you ride down the east coast. And you see the southern part of the island, there are no villages and no houses. It's just mountains on the right side and ocean on the left side. Then come to the southern tip, there are some strange rocks as well. Hermit rock. And sleeping lion, goats on the street. And then we had breakfast, and from then we went together to the green grasslands, which are on the southwestern side of the island, south of the Hongtou village. And there you have a green grassland, and you can see there's a trail there. It was starting to rain a little bit, we had raindrops on the lens. And we did take photos there of the green grasslands. And then further, if you follow the trend, you come to these cliffs, which are quite impressive, quite surprising. I didn't expect this. And there you can see the beautiful water down there. It's quite high up, maybe 30, 50 meters. So you have to be careful, don't get too close to the to the edge. And we made photos there. I don't think you can go down to the beach, to the water. I didn't see any trail down there. It's quite steep. Could be a good site for rock climbers. And beautiful how the water is so azure. Then the distance you can see little Lanyu again. So Lanyu. And this is also a nice spot for watching the sunset when the weather is fine. Then we went further down the coast again to the southern tip, and there is another interesting rock, which is called the Dragon Head Rock, which is looking like this. I'm not sure what the dragon head is, maybe the top part. You can see it looks a bit like a dragon. Very strange. And then we went further, a bit further down south, and there are two more rocks, the Sleeping Lion Rock and the Elephant Tree Rock. I don't know which is which. Well, I can't see any lion and I can't see any elephant trunk. but looks interesting. And then it was time for lunch, for dinner. And we went back to Hongtou Village on the western coast, and there's a small restaurant where we had, first we had ice cream. First we saw the fat sausage dog and a fat cat, and both were fighting a little bit. And then we had lunch. First, this ice cream, and this is a fried flying fish with rice, and I had a curry rice, quite tasty. And these are some tourists. They enjoyed their time at Lanyu. Yeah, victory. And also at Hongtou Village there are some souvenir shops where you can buy souvenirs. This is one of them. And there was a stray dog outside. And then it was, we went to the Lan'an Cultural and Educational Foundation close to the airport, and they have some exhibits about local culture. And there's also this interesting building where we made photos. And then it was almost time to get back to Taiwan, and I had an hour or so time, so I went back to the coast, and this is actually the spot where we did go snorkeling. And I had a final look at the western coast, and I go through the water and listen to the waves. That's something. And then it was back on the ship, on the ferry, and we saw the same group we saw when we came, and they were exactly as before. And then we saw a yacht, sailing boat, and you can see the weather changed. The minute we went, we left the harbor, it started raining, so we had not much luck during our trip. For 2 days on Lanyu, we had no rain at all, just a few drops maybe. And then we left the harbor, and so the ferry was turning. So we only spent 2 days. Would have been nicer to stay a few more days, but we had a great time there. I really enjoyed the scenery, and snorkeling, of course, great snorkeling, and talking to the guesthouse owner was also interesting. He told us a lot about Lani and the people there, and we learned quite a lot. So you can see it was really, the weather was really changing to the worse. And that's one thing you have to watch out for. If you plan to go to Lanyu, make sure that you follow the weather forecast. Because during bad weather, often the flights are cancelled or the ferries are cancelled. And especially during the summer when there are typhoons approaching, you better don't go there, because you might get stranded on the island for a few days because there's no ferries or planes going. Also, during bad weather, if the ferries are going, it can be quite hard if you get seasick quite easily, so you better bring seasick pills. Yeah, thanks for watching. That's all for today. Hope you liked what you saw. Going to Lanyu is very much recommended. So different from Taiwan, and it's a really interesting place. So if you want to more about Taiwan, you can read our magazine online, or you can download the iPad app. You can also visit us on Facebook, and you can watch more videos on this channel. You can subscribe to the channel, and we will post more videos soon. Yeah. Thanks again for watching, and see you again soon. Bye bye.